The question has been asked, what is unique about Abraco? Well, let me say first of all that Abraco, as a minister of the gospel during the Dutch Second Reformation, was not really all that unique if we compare him to his contemporaries. But the better question would be, is what is unique about his magnum opus, his work, The Christian's Reasonable Service? Because we can say of that work that it truly is a systematic theology. In other words, he systematically expounds the essential doctrines of the Word of God, and does so among the accepted framework of the six loci of Reformed theology. So if you would look at the table of contents of his work, you will notice that the book is ordered in that fashion. But what is the unique feature of this work is that not only is it a good and, I would say, excellent systematic theology, in which Abraco proves himself to be a very capable and competent theologian, but it is a systematic theology that includes the personal application to the reader. In other words, whenever Abraco treats of a doctrine, he always makes personal application. He always deals with how does the believer benefit from this specific doctrine. What does this mean for the spiritual life of the believer? That's why we could say that The Christian's Reasonable Service is an experiential systematic theology. So what do we mean by experiential? Because that truly was one of the hallmarks of the Dutch Second Reformation, and is one of the hallmarks of Puritanism, is that it is experiential in nature. The preaching of these men was experiential preaching. What we mean by experiential preaching is that preaching in which not only the doctrines of Scripture are expounded, but in which personal application is made to the believer. In other words, it is a preaching that addresses how that the truths of God's Word are experienced in the lives of believers. And that is what Abraco does in his Christian's Reasonable Service. He always includes the experiential application of the truth that he has expounded. And that's what makes his work so very valuable. That's why we could say that his Christian's Reasonable Service is a devotional systematic theology, and is therefore a work that is utterly unique in the genre of systematic theologies. Let me give you an example of an application that he makes in the chapter entitled Christ's Humiliation, by which he made satisfaction. This is found in volume 1. And so in the beginning of that chapter, Brackel expounds the doctrine of Christ's humiliation. And at the end of the chapter, he makes the application. Let me quote, "As necessary as it is to know the truth and perfection of Christ's satisfaction in the state of his humiliation, as well as its restriction to God's children only, so beneficial and soul-stirring it is also to make application of it by faith, to consider this truth by way of holy meditation, to persevere in obtaining a proper frame of heart, and to grow by virtue of this frame, are exercises which are hidden for many, even for believers. Truly, if a person had more faith to clearly perceive these truths, and were to be more occupied with a quiet and sweet meditation upon the suffering of Christ, the severity of that suffering would be better perceived. He would have a deeper insight into the abominable nature of sin and the sublime nature of God's righteousness. He would rejoice more in the truth and perfection of the satisfaction accomplished by that suffering. He would love Christ more, hate sin more, have a heart more steadfast in the practice of godliness, and proceed with more courage, comfort, and peace. Therefore, actively and increasingly engage yourselves in these considerations. And thus, I've given you an illustration of how a Brakel makes the experiential application. Because that was his goal. His goal was to minister to the Church of God. His goal was to minister to the people of God. The writing of this work was not an academic exercise for him. He viewed it as preaching. He viewed it as ministering to the Church of God in the Netherlands. And he expresses the desire even that someday he might be able to minister to God's church around the world.